the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who made the priest Saint Christopher Magallanes and his companions faithful to Christ the King, even to the point of martyrdom, grant us through their intercession that persevering in confession of the true faith, we may always hold fast to the commandments of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul reached also Derbe and Lystra, where there was a disciple named Timothy, the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. The brothers in Lystra and Iconium spoke highly of him, and Paul wanted him to come along with him. On account of the Jews of that region, Paul had him circumcised, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they traveled from city to city, they handed on to the people for observance the decisions reached by the apostles and presbyters in Jerusalem. Day after day, the churches grew stronger in faith and increased in number. They traveled through the Phrygian and Galatian territory because they had been prevented by the Holy Spirit from preaching the message in the province of Asia. When they came to Mysia, they tried to go on into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So they crossed through Mysia and came down to Troas. During the night, Paul had a vision. A Macedonian stood before him and implored him with these words, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." When he had seen the vision, we sought passage to Macedonia at once, concluding that God had called us to proclaim the good news to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Know that the Lord is God. He made us. His we are. His people, the flock he tends.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
The Lord is good, his kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If the world hates you, realize that it hated me first. If you belong to the world will love its own. But because you do not belong to the world, and I have chosen you out of the world hates you. Remember the word I spoke to you. No slave is greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep yours. And they will do all these things to you on account of my name, because they do not know the one who sent me." My brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Maayong aga sa tanan. Kumusta po kayo? Salamat sa Diyos, mabuti, maayo. Tapos na ang eleksyon, may nagdaog na at may naperde. May ara mga nagse-celebrate, masaya, nagdiwang kay ang kanilang manok ay nagdaog. At tanggapin natin na may ara mga nasubo, nalungkot. At hindi lang nalungkot, hasta subong, nagtatanong, asa subong, nagluluksa. Siyempre, hindi pa rin klaro ang mga bagay-bagay, kaya aragid tayo sa sitwasyon na nagtatanong at nasubo. Tapos na ang eleksyon. Pero, hindi naman din ang epekto ng eleksyon ay physical, mental, no? May ara mga tao na naapektuhan spiritual. No? May ara isa ka-volunteer na talaga namang faithful na nag-open up sa akon at talaga namang na-challenge ang kanyang spiritual life dahil nga sa experience niya sa eleksyon. Siling niya sa akon, "Father, nagdasal naman tayo. Father, ang buong simbahan, nag-vigil, nagsimba, nag-volunteer, walang hinto ang ating pagdarasal. Nag-house to house tayo at talaga namang pinuntahan natin ang kasuluk-sulukan. Nga itong natabo, nga at sila niya sa akon, "Bakit pinayagan ni Lord na ganito? Bakit pinayagan niya? Hindi nagkulang ang simbahan sa pag-educate, sa pag-promote ng maayong mabalita, pagdarasal, pagsisimba, pagnonovena, pagrorosaryo. Nga natabo, hindi tayo pinakinggan ni Lord. Tang sabi sa akon, hindi muna po ako magsisimba dahil nagaakig siya sa Ginoo. It is also a spiritual challenge sa mga nangyari ngayon. Ano bang sagot mo dyan, no? Bilang isang pari at ngayon diri sa katalingban, no? Siling ko lang sa kanya, kahit ako, ganito ang tanong ko, nga, pero hindi ako nag-aakig sa Ginoo. At hindi man ito maging dahilan para madula ang akong pagtuo. Spiritual awakening nga ito, itong natabo. Kay nakikita natin ang plano ng Diyos at ang Diyos may maayong plano. Hindi ako nagagalit kay Lord at hindi rin ako pwedeng magduda sa kanyang presensya. At sabi ko sa kanya, at ito ang ebanghelyo. Ang ebanghelyo subong, ang good news na pangahawakan natin. Sabi ko sa kanya, bumalik tayo sa kwento ni Jesus. Gaya ng sinasabi ni Santa Teresa, our Holy Mother, fix your eyes on Jesus. Balik tayo sa kwento ni Jesus at maintindihan natin at magkaroon tayo ng matibay na pananaw sa mga nangyayari. Siling ko, tingnan mo ang buhay ni Jesus, ang ating Ginoo. Balikan mo. Ito ay punto para din mag-deepen ang atong pagkilala at pagtuo kay Jesus. Si Jesus, ginawa na niya ang lahat nung siya ay aragin sa duta. Nagbigay na siya ng milagro, nag-ayo ang masakiton, nagkadto sa mga pobre, sa mga laylayan, sa lipunan. Ibinigay na niya ang kanyang sarili. Bumaba para tayo ay maabot. Si Hesukristo sa kanyang gugma. Pero anong natabo? Mas pinili ng mga tao kung din sila mas komportable. Mas pinili ng mga tao si Barabas. Ang hantungan ni Hesukristo, ang paglansang sa krus. Konti man ang nagtuo, konti man nagpati kay Jesus, ginawa na niya ang lahat. Ginawa, to the point ay binigay na niya ang kanyang sarili, ang kanyang kaugalingon para sa aton. Pero, pinili pa rin ang mga tao si Barabas. Ilansang sa krus si Jesus at si Barabas ang pinili at palayain. Ngayon, itong nangyayaring ito sa atong kasalukuyang panahon, gusto ng tao, kahit anong gawin natin, ang dilim, ang komportable, ang makakuha. Marami ang kumita ngayong nakaraang eleksyon. Akala ko hindi totoo, pero totoo. Hindi lang isa o dalawa o tatlo ang naririnig ko. Kumita ngayong eleksyon. Ang tataas ng vote buying price, pinakamababa ang 500. Gusto mong kumita? At ang mga tao dahil uhaw sa pera, dahil sa hirap, gutom? Kung punta ka sa isang kandidato, magbibigay ng 500. Maririnig yan, tataasan, 1,000. Punta sa isang kandidato, another 1,500. At ang ano, lantaran na po. Kung hindi man yan digital, i-deliver ang sobre sa bahay nyo. At ang sobre, ayuda daw. Pero vote buying na yun. Kaya hindi pwedeng mahuli eh, kasi ayuda. So kumita 7,000, 8,000, 9,000 dahil lahat ng kandidato, halos, doon may mga marangal pa rin kandidato. Siyempre, ang pobreng Juan de la Cruz, dahil kailangan niya ng pambayad ng kuryente, kailangan niya ng pang-enroll ng mga bata, uhaw sa pera, ay ang volunteer, hindi naman nagbibigay ng pera yan. Tayo ang naglalabas. Nakatanggap ba kayo ng pera, vote buying? Kapag marangal kayo, hindi lalapit sa iyo yan. Ngayon, huwag nating sisihin ang mga tao. Kailangan talagang kailangan nila, no? Pero mas pinipili nila ang dilim. At ito ang ebanghelyo subong. Siling dito, if the world persecutes you, remember that I also persecute, that I was also the first being persecuted. Si Jesus mismo, huwag na tayong lumayo sa kwento ni Jesus. At ito naman ang ating tunay na pagtuo. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Ayaw ng mga tao ng liwanag. Kahit anong gawin natin. Dahil nalason na ang mentality, ang pag-iisip ng marami sa fake news, sa propaganda, sa mga ads, sa kultura, at ang kahirapan ng mga tao, mas uhaw sa pera, mas uhaw sa komportableng buhay, kung ano ang natatanggap ng mga kamay. Ngayon, ang tanong, may pag-asa ba? May pag-asa. Kasi ang atong pagtuo, nakasalig kay Yesu Kristo. Move on ta, pero mahirap. Pero tayong mga Kristiyano-Katoliko na hindi nabahiran ng vote buying, na tanging volunteerism, bayanihan, pagtuo, paninindigan sa katotohanan, hindi dapat madula ang atong respeto sa kada isa at pagtuo sa Ginoo. There is a plan in everything. God's will reigns. In the end, Jesus reigns. Mga utod, may ara tayo madaku na assignment, challenge sa aton. Una, I congratulate each one of you. Ginawa natin ang lahat. Nanindigan tayo. At sa ating paninindigan, bisan hindi nagtuo, nagpati ang madamo, pero tayo nagtuo. At yon ay isang grasya. Hindi natin pinaghihinayangan at hindi natin sinisisi kung bakit ito ang mga pinili natin. Tayo ay nanindigan sa katotohanan. Pero may assignment tayo. Una, matindi ang fake news, ang propaganda, ang revisionism. Lason na pumasok na sa maraming tao, maraming Pilipino, mayaman, mahirap, nasa city o nasa uma, matanda o bata, ang internet, ang social media, bahagi ng buhay ng bawat Pilipino. At lason, ang karamihan na pinapasok dahil sa mga agenda ng maraming tao. Anong magagawa natin? Mahirap, complicated na, kasi matagal na yan eh. Matagal na at nakapasok na sa sistema ng pag-uutak, pag-iisip ng mga tao. Ganito ang gawin natin, simple lang, kahit maliit na bagay pero may magagawa. Huwag natin tangkilihin ang fake news. Kapag alam ninyo na ang fake news, yung nasa video, nasa Facebook, nasa internet, nasa Twitter, nasa YouTube, shorts o mga TikTok, may option doon na i-report nyo na malicious, fake news, bullying, false truth. Pwede po kayong mag-report. I-click nyo lang yung option sa menu. Kapag may maraming mga tao na nagre-report ng isang video ay fake news, malicious, makikinig naman ang Facebook o ang YouTube o ang mga social network media. Kaya napansin nyo noong election, maraming binlock kasi maraming nag-report. Pero talagang matindi nga lang talaga ho. No? Matindi talaga ang, actually tsunami siya. Hindi lang siya tsunami, talagang deluge ang fake news. Pangalawa, padayon tayo sa gugma. Oo, alam natin, walang judgment, hindi tayo nagkukondinar sa atong mga kababayan na pinili kung ano ang kanilang boto, respeto. Ibalik natin ang maayo na relasyon sa kanila. sa ating mga utod, kapamilya, kapuso na hindi nagboto ayon sa gusto natin, ayon sa pagnilay natin, karapatan po nila yan. Demokrasya tayo. Respeto, at sila din respetuhin tayo. Dahil in the end, kapag nasa krisis tayo, kapag tayo ay nasa pagsubok, ang lalapitan naman talaga ang pamilya. Ang lalapitan ang mga kamag-anak, ang lalapitan ang mga kaibigan. Hindi ang politiko. Itaga natin sa bato. Ngayon lang, May 9, nagkaroon tayo ng pera. Pero these 3 years, and then 6 years, swerte mo kapag may nakuha ka na bulig o ayuda. Swerte mo. At ibig sabihin kapag nag-aayuda kahit walang eleksyon ang isang kandidato, tama siyang kandidato. Pero ngayon, itaga niyo sa bato, ewan ko lang. But na lang, nakatanggap kayo kahit sa maling paraan. Para padayon tayo sa gugma, respeto, kaibigan pa rin natin sila, kaibigan pa rin tayo, kapamilya, kapuso pa rin tayo. Gugma. Ang ating pamamaraan ay gugma. Hindi hate, gugma. Hindi bullying, hindi disrespect, hindi bashing, kundi gugma. Respeto, pasensya, at padayon sa panglakaton. At ang panghuli, the good news. Ito ang ating panalo, ito ang ating victory. Fix your eyes on Jesus lagi. Nanalo man ang manok nila, natalo man ang manok naton, pero nanalo tayo kay Jesus. Kapag may problema kang pinagdadaanan, ano man yan, fix your eyes on Jesus. Dahil bago naman tayo nagdusa, kinere na ni Jesus yan. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Focus your eyes on Jesus. Si Jesus ang atong victory. At doon, hindi tayo mawawala. At kailanman, hindi tayo madula. Mga utod, there is so much hope and there is so much energy in these times. But we have to be courageous to always make a stand for Jesus. Our intercessions. The Lord Jesus is a sign that is contradicted. May we, his followers, never be ashamed of this gospel, of the truth, for it is the power of God for the salvation of those who believe. Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
Like the Lord Jesus and Saint Stephen, may we ask forgiveness for our enemies, for they do not know what they are doing. We pray.
Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
May we bear the persecution and defamation of those who reject Christ and his gospel, happy to be considered worthy to suffer for the sake of Jesus. We pray.
Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
May we never avenge ourselves, but leave the Lord to protect us and work out his justice. We pray.
Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
May we repay hatred with love, that we may heap burning coals on the heads of our enemies, so that they may be shamed and be overwhelmed by our kindness. We pray.
Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
May we, like Zechariah, pray to the Lord to rescue us from the hands of our enemies, that we may serve him without fear, in holiness and righteousness. We pray.
Lord, deliver us from those who hate us.
Almighty God, let us never be ashamed of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that someday he may acknowledge us before you and the angels and saints in heaven. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of dirt and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the divine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice and our sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
In honor of the precious death of your just ones, O Lord, we come to offer that sacrifice from which all martyrdom draws its origin, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And their struggle and the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we with all the hosts of angels cry out without end, we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricia, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all the consecrated. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles, with all the saints, with all the martyrs of today, Saint Christopher Magallanes and companions, we have blessed you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Christ.
Amen.
For those who are joining our live stream celebration, let us now pray the Spiritual Communion Prayer. O my Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you and I desire you to come into my heart. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you. O never leave me. May the burning and most sweet power of your love consume me, that I may die for you who died for love of me. Amen.
Let us pray. As we celebrate by this divine banquet the heavenly victory of the blessed martyrs, Christopher Columbus, priests and companions, we beseech you, Lord, to bestow victory on those who eat here below of the bread of life and to allow them to eat as victors from the tree of life in paradise. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oratio imperata against the spread of COVID-19.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death. Restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen.
Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Sebastian,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
We now come to our Mother, to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, in this beautiful Saturday morning. We pray for our country and also for our newly elected officials. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.
Amen.